Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya al-mursaleen wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome, brothers and sisters, to this session, Dawah, the Prophetic Mission. Inshallah, we have a number of speakers in this session, and the session will conclude with a Q&A session. We're going to go to our next presenter, inshallah, Imam Omar Suleiman, inshallah, who is the founder and CEO of Yaqeen Institute for Islamic Research. And inshallah, his title is Make a Wish. Shaykh Omar.
Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والعاقبة للمتقين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. So subhanAllah, the title of this session is actually taken from a famous narration with Umar bin Khattab رضي الله تعالى عنه, where Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was sitting with the companions and he asked them to make a wish. He asked them to wish for anything. And so one of them said that they wished that they could have as much gold as would fill the building so that they could spend it fi sabilillah. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu continued to prompt them to say, make a wish, make a wish. And they, you know, most of the Sahaba or all of them that were speaking about having things that they could give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to spread the message of Islam. And as they kept on being prompted, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I wish this home was full of men like Abu Ubaydah Ibn Al-Jarraah, Mu'adh Ibn Jabal, and Salim, Mawla Abi Hudhayfah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, to use them to spread the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, what that is, what it speaks to is that Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu was speaking about the power of having actual people that are dedicated and committed to this deen. That what is encompassed in the people like Abu Ubaidah and Mu'adh and Salim, may Allah be pleased with all of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is so profound and is something that that outdoes any other type of possession in this world. A person who is committed to Allah and to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to spreading the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنْ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And what is better, who is better in speech than the one who calls to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and works acts of righteousness and says that I am from amongst the Muslims. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this person and the way that they live their lives, completely giving themselves to Allah and to this wonderful deen that we have of Islam. And subhanAllah, as we think about that, and you know, often when you attend fundraisers and you see the hands that go up for the checks that are written and you see the buildings that are built, you know, I often wish that we could fundraise for volunteers. And subhanAllah, often, you know, you feel like as you're building these institutions, just the importance of reminding all of us that the goals of these institutions are to nurture individuals that will then spread the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the world in a way that would make our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam proud, that would gain the acceptance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam proud. And that the human capacity, when a human being accepts this religion and then lives by this religion and then spreads this religion, is unmatched in terms of the other things that we have, the material things that we have to use for the purpose of seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, even when you think about the prophets of Allah, when you think about how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described the house of the prophets, and he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam that his example to the rest of the prophets is like this beautiful home. And as people walk by that home and they marvel at the beauty of that home, there's this one missing brick and they praise the home, but they say, if only that one brick was there. If only that one brick was there. And the Prophet ﷺ is the completion of that structure of thousands of prophets, thousands of anbiya that have come along, all of them calling to tawheed, all of them calling to Allah Azza wa Jalla, all of them upon divine revelation and righteousness, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam being the culmination of it all. the completion of that building of the prophets. You then think about the building of this ummah. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he looked out on the night of al-Isra wal-Mi'raj and he saw this enormous ummah, this enormous group of people, and he thought sallallahu alaihi wasallam that it must be his ummah, and they said this is the ummah of Musa alayhi salam. And then he was turned to alayhi salatu wasalam, a much larger group of people, a group of people that made even that group of people small. And he was told by Jibreel alayhi salam that this is your ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those, Allahumma ameen, that are standing behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam on the Day of Judgment, that are drinking from his hands on the Day of Judgment, and that are surrounded, that surround him alayhi salatu wasalam as his neighbors in Jannat al-Firdaus. Allahumma ameen. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was amazed by the size of this ummah. Looking out at the size of this ummah, he also, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, was pleased when he looked out and he saw his companions in prayer, because there was a continuity that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam wished to see. As he looked out, alayhi salatu wasalam, he saw his companions in prayer, then he was pleased, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that he fulfilled his mission, alayhi salatu wasalam, that he did what he did, that all the blood, sweat, and tears of 23 years had paid off, because the Prophet ﷺ was leaving this ummah when it was in the hands of the likes of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Umar, Uthman, and Ali, may Allah be pleased with them all. There's a continuity. And the Prophet ﷺ would say, Hum ikhwani, hum ahbabi. They are my brothers, they are my beloved ones. They said, who is it, Ya Rasulullah? And he said, ﷺ, he's not talking about the Ansar or the Muhajireen. He's talking about those who believed in the Prophet ﷺ and they've never even seen him. The diversity of this ummah, looking around the world, the people reciting the Quran all around the world, the different colors and different languages and different cultures, all united around the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as taught by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's stunning. And it's something that you think about with regards to the building that this ummah constitutes, right? That we are a building, that we are a home, and we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us useful bricks to that home, the body of Islam as it goes through generation and generation, calling to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, calling to others to believe in him alayhi salatu wasalam, his message, without having seen him as we have believed in him alayhi salatu wasalam, without having seen him. And so, you know, it's just a reminder as this time goes on, that if the Prophet ﷺ said that if Allah Azza wa Jal was to guide by your hand one person, then it's better for you than the world and all that it contains. When we think about this at the institutional level, if our institutions are able to provide, to nurture just one, you know, one Muslim who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Messenger ﷺ, and who practices their religion proudly and calls people to this deen, and serves with this deen, then the entirety of that institution is worth it. That's better than the entire world. That the success of the institution is the type of individuals that it can produce in that regard. And there is no way, you know, we have people here, you know, alhamdulillah, and I want to, because sometimes we wait for people to die in order to thank them. Man la yashkur innas la yashkur illah. We have someone like Imam Siraj Wahaj with us. How many institutions have been built by Imam Siraj, hafidhahullah ta'ala? Right, so one individual means so much when that individual is committed to this cause, the cause of Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and can produce so much good that can outlive us and that can last for generations, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, calling them to Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, all of us meeting the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, while He's proud of us on the Day of Judgment. May Allah Azza wa Jalla make us amongst those who the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is proud of on the Day of Judgment, and who are gathered with the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the highest level of Jannat al-Firdaus. Allahumma ameen. And, you know, just as I complete these words, I want to actually just say about, you know, this work in particular, that subhanAllah, ICNA is a pioneering organization. Why Islam is pioneering work, gain peace is pioneering work. The amount of good that Why Islam has done as a subsidiary, and gain peace has done as a subsidiary of ICNA, you cannot put a price tag on that. And I remember, you know, subhanAllah, you know, just going out and putting the pamphlets on the doors in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, actually, there's a brother, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and preserve him, Brother Ed. Brother Edward, who would take out youth every Sunday morning, and we'd go and we just put pamphlets, hundreds of pamphlets on people's doors. And all we had were the Why Islam pamphlets. And he, I don't want to say we because I don't want to take from his credit. He, a convert himself, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and preserve him. He mapped out the entire city. And subhanAllah, within a few years, we were able to cover, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, the entire city with those pamphlets. And it was those Why Islam pamphlets. And this is almost 20 years ago that this endeavor was taking place, that he was taking youth to be able to do this. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless these organizations for being there for us and allow us to be there for them. And when we volunteer our time with these organizations, with this effort of da'wah through the likes of ICNA, then it is only for our benefit, bidnillahi ta'ala, that on the Day of Judgment, bidnillahi ta'ala, we find this on our scale of good deeds. So may Allah Azza wa Jalla reward ICNA, Why Islam, Gain Peace for the wonderful work that they're doing. And may Allah Azza wa Jalla allow us to have a share of that work, and may Allah allow all of us to have the entirety of the reward on the Day of Judgment. Allahumma ameen. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah khairan, Imam Umar. And as all of the speakers before us have really emphasized, we can either be watchers and really listen to this presentation and just go away and continue in our lives, or we can be doers. And I'd like to really invite everybody to be a doer. The simplest thing that we can do is really to put Islam in our actions, in our daily lives. But we also need to try and get involved in the work that's ongoing. You can be part of ICNA's Dawah efforts. If you want to volunteer, and one of the things Brother Sheikh Umar Suleiman mentioned is that he wishes we could fundraise for volunteers. And really, there is that opportunity to fundraise for volunteers. Simply go to icna.org/baraka and you can volunteer for many of the activities that are associated with the Dawah work that ICNA is doing. Also, donate with your money and inshallah, be a doer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all tawfiq. So with that, we are out of time for this session. One thing I would like to end with is simply to say that many people are asking the question, well, how do we do Dawah during COVID-19 with lockdown? We're socially distanced. What do we do? On some of the work ICNA is doing to mail out postcards to some of the remote areas in the country, try and get the message of Islam, the invitation to Islam to people, and to complement those mailing efforts with social media campaigns targeted to the same regions, inshallah. So I'd like to end by thanking all of the speakers for the fantastic presentations and the words of inspiration. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to act on these words. Please do donate something for the work of Dawah. Please do volunteer for getting involved in some of the Dawah initiatives that are available to you.